It is official. The Line, a controversial mirrored linear megacity that is a component of Saudi Arabia's ambitious project, Neom City, has started construction. In a recent drone video that circulated on social media, several excavators can be seen digging a long, straight hole in the vast desert in the northwest of the Arab nation. This shows that the city's foundations, which will span 100 miles, is now being constructed. The project initially gained attention in 2017 when flying taxis and robot maids were among the submitted possibilities. People were certain that this was merely a utopian fantasy project that would never get built, and economists and architects questioned its viability. However, fast forward to the present, and construction of this future megacity is currently under progress. In the recently released drone footage, the early stages of the city's building may be seen. The video depicts hundreds of vehicles and machines prepping the construction site in the middle of the desert. Along the whole length of the project, extensive excavation work is currently being done. The line will be 170 kilometers long, 500 meters tall, and 200 meters broad, according to renderings that have already been made public. However, if you pay close attention to the construction video, the trench's breadth does not appear to meet the suggested dimensions. In rendered photos that have been made public, there are vast rivers and waterfalls in the park, sports stadiums, and both residential and business space inside this enormous building. The trench shown in the drone footage is far less than 200 meters, which is about equal to two American football fields. This is reason to suspect that this excavation could merely be preparatory work for the underground high-speed transport system that is planned to be erected beneath the length of the city, since the actual size of the line would ideally be three times the size of this trench. The line is undoubtedly the most striking project being undertaken at the moment in the field of architecture and construction. It will be taller than the Empire State Building, have a massive, stunning mirror glass front, and be able to house 9 million people. Artificial intelligence will be used to help the city function totally on renewable energy. It will be a completely sustainable city since there won't be any roads, cars, or carbon emissions. At the moment, the only evidence of the city's existence is a website and a press release from Saudi Prince Mohammed bin Salman. Despite the glitzy presentation, many design experts think that such a city's technology is still years away. Before we continue, be sure to subscribe to this channel if you would like to learn more about billion-dollar construction projects around the globe. We strive to provide the best and most informative videos about projects, just like The Line, and many more in future videos. According to proposals, The Line is envisioned as a collection of distinctive communities that will be arranged in accordance with the three directions that people can move, up, down, or across. This is described as zero-gravity urbanism. There are three layers: an upper surface layer with parks and open spaces for pedestrians, a lower surface layer, and a subterranean transportation spine with high-speed rail. According to the proposal, trips on the high-speed transit would take no longer than 20 minutes, and all daily services would be accessible on foot within 5 minutes of every node along the line. Some experts claim that these objectives are impossible to achieve. The line would need larger nodes that could accommodate more passengers to provide this degree of public transportation, and if there aren't enough passengers at every stop, it would be impossible to sustain this infrastructure economically. The technology for the transit system on the line may not even exist now. It would take 318 miles per hour to cover 100 miles in 20 minutes, which is far faster than the current high-speed rail. Some of China's high-speed rail trains have achieved speeds of 236 miles per hour, whereas Eurostar trains in Europe move at roughly 199 miles per hour. Theoretically, the Elon Musk-developed Hyperloop technology could handle the travel, but even that technology is still at least 10 years away from being put to use. Some people believe that this initiative is the most expensive publicity gimmick in history, intended to divert attention from a sobering reality. Contrary to popular belief, which claims that Neom is being built on undeveloped ground, the area is really a portion of the Red Sea coastline, one of Saudi Arabia's most neglected regions. 20,000 members of the Bedouin nomadic tribe live in a number of former settlements. They currently do not fit in Neom's plans, and the Saudi government intends to seize the land of the people who have been farming in the region for many generations. One of the group members who resisted giving up his ancestral land was eventually executed by the police, and shortly after his passing, human rights advocates launched a wave of protest. Three further tribe members were recently reported to have received death sentences after being jailed for demonstrating against their forced eviction. Although the forcible displacement of indigenous people may appear to be a major obstacle, it is only just the beginning. Another challenge is extreme heat, which is a major characteristic of Saudi Arabia's desert climate. To combat this, the structures inside the line reflected the mirrors on the outside of the towers away from them. Given how significant the mirrors would need to be, this may have a variety of effects. Any nearby objects might melt in areas where the sun is heated and doubled by reflection from the mirrors. Environmental planning specialists have also criticized the idea because they think that the mirror line's size and length will obstruct bird migration paths. Additionally, a number of wild species will be relocated, and groundwater flow dynamics will be impacted. Given the line's immense scale, it would be impossible to erect a 500-meter structure using low-carbon materials, and a staggering amount of steel, glass, and concrete would be needed to construct the line. The line uses 100 renewable resources and emits no greenhouse gases, yet building it would generate more than 1.8 billion tons of carbon dioxide, or more than 4 years' worth of the UK's entire emissions. This would essentially work against most of the suggested green efforts. Saudi Arabia will need to overcome both internal and foreign obstacles related to financial and technical feasibility in order to construct the line and see it through to completion. The main economic problem Saudi Arabia has is its inability to successfully entice financial support and investment from foreign governments and businesses.
The reason is that many Western nations and businesses have decided to boycott the country due to reports of human rights abuses. While the original goal was to finish NEOM by 2030 with a budget of $500 billion, various reports suggested that it might not be finished until 2050. Costs will probably rise dramatically as a result. $1 trillion is estimated to be spent by the kingdom on the entire project, including the line. The Public Investment Fund and the Sovereign Wealth Private Investment Fund of the kingdom both contributed to the project's funding, but Riyadh has not been successful in forming financial partnerships for the line, with the exception of conversations with a few foreign businesses, particularly Russian ones. The kingdom's oil exports, which have been erratic in recent years, are crucial to the Public Investment Fund's financial viability. This means the financing of this massive project is expected to have ups and downs in a nation where almost 60% of its financial resources come from oil. The initiative also calls for overcoming technological obstacles that Saudi Arabia cannot handle on its own. If it can't get these issues right, the line will be added to the lengthy list of unfinished projects scattered around the Gulf. Despite a projected population of 2 million, King Abdullah Economic City, which required an investment of $10 billion, only had less than 10,000 residents after 10 years. There is also the now-abandoned waterfront project in Dubai, the Blue City in Oman and possibly the most infamous abandoned project in the world, the World Islands in Dubai, which is now sinking back into the sea. So the question still stands, will NEOM do anything to protect it from the same fate? It's still early in the creation of this futuristic city, so it's difficult to predict whether the 100-mile-long metropolis will materialize. It is a daring endeavor that raises the bar for envisioning what cities could look like in the future, and only time will tell whether or not this megacity is really feasible. Let us know what you think about the line by leaving your thoughts in the comments down below. And if you want to see more mega-built videos, be sure to subscribe to the channel. Make sure to give us a like and we will see you in the next video.